better person, a fantastic teacher. I'm just so grateful that she is here in recital tonight. Just a couple of things I want to remind you about, probably things that you already know, things that you've been to other concerts and you've heard those things before. But if you do have small children with you this evening, I don't know if they see any, but if you do, please, if they at any point become a little bit restless during the course of the evening, please feel free to take them out and to enjoy what you hear coming through the door Also, yourselves asked that you refrain from any sort of flash photography, anything that might be distracting in that way, so please don't use any flash photography. And then also, just a reminder that if you have a cell phone with you, that the common thing would be asking you to please make sure you silence the cell phone. And if you can, just use the next few moments as for release from that slave of the cell phone that you have. Manage your attention. The moment that it buzzes, you can't even think about it. Just release yourself from that and enjoy this evening as we expect it to be. And know it will be fantastic. Let me just let you know about a couple of things that are coming up in this we have our printed calendar for you. These are many copies of this are out on the counter in the lobby area. I really invite you pick one of these up and take it home with you so you see what's coming up. A week from tonight, we have another faculty recital. It's actually a joint recital. And it is oboe and violin. Our affiliate faculty members, Jennifer Stuckey on oboe and Kristen Campbell on violin. That will be a week from tonight at this same time at 7:30. So we invite you to come back for that evening. And then on Monday, the 9th of October, we have a few special guests that are coming here in the course of the year to kind of be a part of our students. And our next guest is Jeff Kapmanchin. Jeff is one of the most sought-after orchestrators in Hollywood. He is a phenomenal talent. He orchestrated the Harry Potter movies. I think he also did Lord of the Rings movies. And there's quite a listing in here in this old flyer of his credentials. And that's during our regular music convocation time at 4:30 on Monday, October the 9th. And if you'd like to come, we'd love to have you here. Something we'd be glad to share with you. It's free admission, and it would be a really amazing thing to hear from someone who is so world-renowned and so well-regarded in his field. He's a personal friend of one of our faculty members, Charlie Denver, who, if you haven't met Charlie, also you should meet him. He's got a couple of Emmy Awards for his film scoring. So. A great afternoon. Then coming up are our first ensemble concerts. The first one is the Fall Symphonic Band Concert, and that's on Friday, October 20th. And then the Fall Choral Concert follows that the following week on Saturday, October 28th. I won't go any further than that, but since I didn't give you really time to write all those things down, I just really encourage you to pick all these up. We'd love to have you on. So, Charlie, you want to say anything about Jeff? You're here, I didn't see you before. Father, thank you for Christina. You have blessed us and gifted us with this person in our lives, in our school. And Lord, you have blessed her with great talent and wisdom. I ask, Lord, we will continue that tonight, that you will just flow through her. And as she is a blessing to us, Father, may you also be a blessing to her. And we invite your presence in Jesus' name. Amen.
It's really meant for an audience a lot of times. So I appreciate that. My family probably cringes when I come up here to speak. They don't know what I'm going to say. So, hi, Sarah.
Hi, Alfred.
So the pieces on this program are some favorites of mine. They're favorite composers and pieces that I've taught, pieces that I learned long ago. Some of them are new to me tonight. If you're a pianist, you may well have played a movement that I'm playing tonight or a piece, and that might enhance your enjoyment because sometimes familiarity is makes it even a more fun listening experience. So I hope you'll enjoy and engage with the music. I've always loved Bach and admired musicians who say it's good for the technique, good for the brain, good for musicality to practice a little Bach every day. This particular partita is so gentle and intricate, perfect for indulging your little Bach on a daily basis. For those who are new to recitals, a partita is a set of dances, as I put in the program notes. And the movements you see under the title after the prelude are specific Renaissance dances that had particular steps and particular rhythmic characteristics, which I talked about a little bit in the program notes. These dances became stylized, and by the time of Bach, most of them were not actually danced anymore, except possibly the minuet. As we move through the various dances, I hope you'll enjoy how Bach takes a melodic theme and turns it upside down, puts it in the right hand, then the left hand, and plays around with the tonal relationships. I will play all the dances as a set without a pause between the movements.
Thank you.
Thank you.
But this sonata begins with the movement in the form of theme and variations. The theme is a lilting, sweet melody in 6A time. The style is typically classical, elegant, clean, simple, delicate. But whenever I listen to Mozart, I always hear or listen for the dichotomy between the elegant and gallant young man and the trickster that he also was. I think if you listen carefully, you'll often hear the contrast between the sweet, gentle Mozart and the earthy, silly, in-your-face moments. He can go back and forth between these almost instantaneously, but it's subtle, so you have to listen for it. I must say a word about the third movement, the famous Alla Turca. Even though I wrote about this in the program notes, Mozart lived in Vienna, and the Viennese had a fascination with Turkish music. The Turkish Janissary band had a lot of brass and lots of percussion. Their music was very march-like and militaristic. The Viennese loved this music. Mozart, as well as Haydn and Beethoven, all wrote pieces imitating this. This Turkish march you'll hear tonight is no exception. Whenever you hear rolled chords in the left hand, it's probably imitating some kind of drum, probably with cymbals. On some pianos of Mozart's time, there was a Janissary stop, which a pedal which you could depress to add drums and cymbals whenever you wanted it. I'm sure that's what Mozart was composing for in this piece. So imagine the moments in the third movement where that would happen. You can still find some of these 18th century pianos with a Janissary stop in musical instrument museums, so I encourage you to look for that sometime. I toyed with the thought of having my own little percussion ensemble, but maybe another time.
Thank you.
Silence. What follows then is a retelling of that story, so to speak, in the left hand, with the right hand providing commentary at the same time. To me, perhaps in its painful dissonance, we feel the pain of the story. In each of us, there is a little of all of us. We have all had incredible pain in life. No one is exempt. That's part of the human condition. This piece ends the way it began, with those eerie, surreal, plucked notes. The difference is that it ends on a C major chord. We Christians believe in that ending. We believe in that redemption. I hope you hear it in this piece. So that's the Martin, but now back to the Brahms.
Thank you. Thank you.